Let's make simple interlocking rings in an SVG. And I'm also going to show you how to make it for print because there are two different approaches for this. So first thing you want to do is pull up your donut tool. If the shape isn't showing right away, you'll just pull it down and find it in the menu here. Make a donut any size you'd like. You do want to size your rings to what you want their final size to be before you start doing any, we're gonna do some masking here, or not masking, we're gonna use this vector crop tool. So I'm gonna double click on my donut, and that allows me to pull the radius in and out. And now I'm gonna bring this down, and I'm just going to change the color, and then copy and paste it. I want the center one to be green. It's summer here in Chicagoland, so I'm going with bright summery colors right now. We're gonna make this final one yellow. Now, this is super simple. If you're just printing your interlocking rings, so for example, I make coloring posters in Affinity. If I were just creating a coloring poster with rings, all I would have to do is to pull, I want this pink ring to look like it's coming up from the center of the green ring and then over the top. So I'm gonna copy and paste my pink ring. I'm gonna go into my layers panel and put it right above the green. And all I have to do here is a crop. And I'm just pulling the crop up, and there we go. Now these are interlocked. I'm gonna do the same thing with yellow. I'm gonna copy and paste it. Oops, not yellow, with green. I'm gonna copy and paste my green. I'm gonna pull it above my yellow ring. And I'm going to crop it right here, except now I need to pull in my layers panel this pink one back on top. And here we go. So now you just have these three simple interlocking rings. I'm gonna group these to show you how you can change them. So if I were making a coloring page with interlocking rings, I would just turn them white and then give them a black stroke, and here we go. Now, you could not just pull this out, export as an SVG for a cut file, because I'm gonna show you what happens. I took this print version, I exported it as an SVG, and when I pull it into Cricut Design Space, you just see five basic donuts, and that's because the Design Space software does not recognize your clipping paths, so all of those crops that we did, it doesn't recognize those, so it just sees the five layers of rings in this messy version right here. So, what if you want to create an SVG? What if you want to cut vinyl out of interlocking rings? Here's how you're going to do it. Same process. You start with the donut, create a donut. I'm going to do that really fast here. Once again, you can just change the radius, anything you want. I'm going to pull this one down. My children are home. You can probably hear them in the background. All right, we're gonna make this one pink. I'm gonna copy and paste it. I'm gonna make this one green. One more time. Okay, so I've copied and pasted my three rings, and here's what we're gonna do to create a really super clean SVG. We want our final shapes to only appear where the actual color appears. So you can see when I'm in the node tool mode, you can see that this pink curve, it has a space right where the green is. And then the green, same thing. There's a space and a space where the yellow appears. And so that's what we want our final things, our final rings to look like. So here's how we make that happen. I'm gonna do the same thing where I copy and paste my pink donut first. I'm gonna transform the color. I'm gonna make it black so you can see what I'm doing more easily. I'm gonna pull it above the green because what I'm trying to do here is I wanna cut this out where these overlap. That didn't work, I thought it would. I wanna cut this pink out of the green right here. So, in order to do that, I'm gonna draw a box on top of the part of my donut that I don't wanna cut out. So I'm putting a box over the top of the ring, and then I'm just going to use my subtract tool, and it leaves me with this small curve here that only overlaps the green where I want to cut it out. I'm going to select that black curve in the green. I'm going to subtract, and that has now taken care of the curve right here. And so now I'm going to do it again. I'm going to copy and paste my green donut. I'm going to pull it above the yellow. I'm going to look at my guide. So I want the green overlapping on the bottom. So I'm going to do the same process again. I'm going to draw a black rectangle, subtract it from my black curve, and now I'm going to select the black curve and the yellow, subtract. So now my interlocking rings look great, but I need to make sure that I don't have any extra curves hidden under other curves, because we don't want any layers, especially if your end user is using vinyl. You don't want people layering up vinyl on top of each other. That's just messy design. So let's start with the green. So right here you can see that I need to cut this part out of my green. So I'm going to do the same exact process again. I'm copying and pasting this yellow curve. This is called designing with kids at home. I'm going to add a rectangle over the bottom. I probably don't even need to do this actually, because it isn't covering the green down there. But anyway, I'm going to select the two, subtract it. What happened there? Did you see that? Oh, did you see what happened? So my rectangle wasn't all the way down. So now I have this funky little situation, or my rectangle was too high. So I just did a bunch of Control Z. Control Z is my very favorite shortcut in Affinity. I use it all the time. So I'm going to select the two curves again. Nope. I'm going to select the black curve and my green curve. I'm going to subtract, and now I'm going to do another check to make sure that my curves are all perfect. So here again, I have a situation where the pink curve, I need to cut that out so it isn't over. I don't want any overlap. It all needs to be super, super clean. We're going to do the same process again. I'm going to put this black rectangle over. I'm going to select the two, subtract. Let's see how this looks. So here I see no overlap, so the pink is perfect. Finally, there's no overlap or under anything under the green, and the yellow is perfect. So what I have here are three super clean curves. So now I'm going to select my three curves. I'm going to click export. I'm going to export selection only, digital, small size. And now check it out. Check out how it looks in Cricut Design Space compared to the last one that just gave us five donuts. So you can see here, these are not interlocking. That's the print version. But when I insert these, we have three basic cuts, and you can see everything is preserved here. So when you go to cut, if you're cutting out of vinyl or paper or whatever, you will have zero overlap. And there you go. So I hope you had fun. If you have any requests for how-tos, I love making these tutorials. Please subscribe, like, comment, and comment with your requests, and I will make new ones. Have a great day. Happy designing.